Hey guys, it's Alex Pipe Prof here. I am doing a little work from home. About to light up my Danish spool-shaped corn cob with my fancy aftermarket stem here. With a little, if I can get this flame to go, with a little Uptown's honey mead. Yeah. Very good. And coming to you today because I had a very, I thought a very interesting question and comment on one of my recent videos from another YouTube pipe smoker. I think it's New Start 1561. Hope I'm getting that right. Anyway, New Start 1561, get that light on me, asked a question about pipe filters, because I was talking about one with one of my other corn cobs the other day, and whether or not it would help get rid of some of the wetness. So I thought I'd just briefly share a little bit of information about filters and what I do to handle some of the wetness. So I smoke a lot of aromatics. I mean, I'm smoking honey mead right now, right? And so I get a gurgle frequently. This one's not filtered, so I got a little tobacco just there. One of the things that I've noticed is that if you smoke just a little more calmly, usually the gurgle doesn't exist. So part of my problem is I just tend to puff like a chimney. But if you're not puffing like a chimney and you're using a corn cob pipe that's filtered, right, it will have one of these Medico filters that you can get. They're really cheap. You can get them off of aristocob.com and many other places. They just fit in right here, and they'll filter out some of the nastiness that you might not want, including some moisture, although it's not perfect. What I find them to be more helpful for is cooling down the smoke, especially if there's a wide, I don't know what the right word for it is, hole in your stem that is allowing a lot of air to come through. Sometimes those can be hot smokes, especially if you're doing aromatics. Okay. So I do use filters sometimes, but not often. I'm not using one now. In fact, all of my corn cobs where I have the different stems, let's see if I can get this to lighten up a little, where I have these aftermarket stems, I don't use filters for any of those. I don't even know if they make it so that you can use filters with them, but I don't really care. This one has a filter, and I smoked one that I got out of my grab bag the other day with a filter. I also have some briar pipes that use filters. Many of my Savinelli's are filtered. This is my Giordano briar that I bought in Germany, actually. It's a lovely pipe, great smoke. Kind of a small bowl, so you know you can... it's not an all-day smoke, but you can refill it, I guess, after you let it rest a little. But I use, you can get specific filters for this. I think they're 9mm, and you'll see them, maybe 6mm, 6mm. You'll see them on some websites for sale, and they look like little cylinders, and they usually have charcoal or something in them. However, what I use are these balsa filters. You can get these. This is Savinelli balsa. You can get these at any pipe store, just about, or tobacco store. They're really cheap. I think this was $1, maybe. Comes with a ton in there, right? And they're just these little balls of things. You break them off. I want to show you in this. So I just took this apart, and you can see how it fits in there, right? So there's a little space that's left for the filter. And you just fit it in there, and there you go. And when I smoke using these, it cools the smoke down quite a bit. I mean, it does does take away some of the bite, especially if you're not smoking an aromatic. I don't mind the bite so much with aromatics because it's a sweet bite, and I have apparently a sweet tooth. What I find to be a solution for Gurgle isn't really filters, and I don't know if that was Neustart 1561's question or not. What I find is that, there's the old method, and you might have seen other people do this. If you're outside and you get a Gurgle, you give the pipe a flick, making sure to, hold it in a flick, and some of the moisture that's built up will come out of the stem. It always makes for a nasty taste when you put it back on your mouth, because there's still some residue there, but you could do that. But I recommend, instead of doing that, if you've got a pipe cleaner around, just run that bad boy in there, almost all the way to the end. Give it a couple little pushes, and you pull it out. I don't know if you can see that, but it's wet. If I feel it, it feels wet, and it's a little tinged brown, and Gurgle goes away. If I know that it's going to be gurgly, or if I have a pipe that's especially gurgly, or if I'm going to be smoking an aromatic that's really wet, I'll make sure I have a pipe cleaner around. And I think that really does the job much better than any filter, because filters aren't really meant to handle the Gurgle type thing. So, there's my 2 cents. I hope you guys are doing well. I love smoking pipes. I will see you later.